Today for your garden, there are all kinds of motivations for gardening, but to do a good job, you need the right tools. That's why we have her, Linda Vater, sharing her go-to toolkits.
This is one of my favorite things to do this time of year because it's really still too cold and wet to get outside and dig in the dirt, but I can kind of scratch my gardening itch by organizing and cleaning out my toolkit, my garden trug. And of course, I keep lots of things in there that you would expect, my garden tools, my weeders, my pruners, but here are some things that kind of really help me be efficient and effective in the garden that you might not expect.
Okay.
Okay. So number one, in the past, I have always kept one of these canisters of disinfectant wipes because what I want to do is clean my pruners in between cuts. And what that means is I'm not spreading a black spot or rose rosette, say as I'm pruning my roses or something, or spider mite from one branch to another or one plant to another. But because I'm trying to reduce my plastic and trying to reduce just trash overall, I came up with a better solution. I just got a little cosmetic spray bottle that I fill with rubbing alcohol, and all I have to do is just spritz them and then just take a rag and wipe them off. The other reason this is good to have in your trug, many times I have cut myself in the process of pruning, or I've gotten a rose thorn stuck in my finger or something, and that way I can use it as a first aid kit.
Okay, there you go. How often do you clean this between cuttings? Just between branch to branch?
In between each branch, yes, because it can easily spread different kinds of pathogens or insects from one place in a plant to another place in a plant, or from one plant to another.
Okay.
Okay. I also always keep, whenever I finish a spray bottle of Windex or some kind of household cleaner, if the sprayer still works, I take it off and I put it in my garden trug. The reason why is that many insecticidal soaps or pesticides come in spray bottles, and because the solution is so viscous and thick, they often get clogged up and then they won't work again. So I can just take one out, a replacement, out on my garden trug,
and
I've got one that works.
Buy a new bottle, okay?
Absolutely. I like to always have sunscreen and mosquito off or something like that. For very obvious reasons. Always, I have some washers in my garden trug because every time I'm watering, it seems that there's either a hose that's leaking or a sprayer that's leaking or something. So I don't have to go back in the house and root through my toolkit. I just keep some of them in my garden trug and I can handily fix it.
Yes.
I also like to have, because I have such a problem with squirrels digging around in my bulb gardens and in my container plantings, and they're always making a mess, I can easily clean that up with a little whisk broom and dustpan. Mm-hmm. That way I don't have to get out a large broom or a blower.
Okay.
Lastly, this is something that I find indispensable, and that's that I keep lots of these old produce bags to reuse because they're handy in so many different ways. Number one, after I use a pair of garden gloves and they're all dirty, muddy, wet, I can just toss them in one of these bags and then put them in my garden trug without getting it dirty.
Okay.
I can also deadhead things like dandelions with their seed heads that scatter everywhere,
yes,
or any kind of weed where the seed heads just go absolutely everywhere. I just take it, I just kind of put it and place it over the seed head, pull it, wrap it up. I can discard it. Voila.
Brilliant lady right here, folks. And you can get lots of great gardening inspiration on Linda's Instagram or check out lindavater.com. Thank you, ma'am.
Sure.